Welcome back to Let's Play, or Let's Interactively Play Steve Jackson's Sorcery. This is the RPG Chick. As always, I like to tell new people that may be watching, this is an interactive Let's Play, so please vote at the end if you are so inclined to determine what will happen next from the choices presented. Now, at the end of last video, well, we're back in the past when this place used to be a verdant lush valley, not the desert it is now. Kind of wish I had more stamina and a lot more rations. So we consider climbing down this well for a moment, but it seems bleak and uninviting in there. As you stand by the well side, you hear a scraping noise from within, and after a few minutes, two curved claws emerge through the opening, hooking onto either side of the well mouth. Something is pulling itself up. Now I have some new voters as of last video, so welcome and thanks so much for voting, guys. The majority rules to dislodge the hooks, which is glad because that's what I wanted to choose. So bon voyage, hopefully. Acting quickly, you knock the hooks free. There's a scream, very human, as the figure inside the well falls. There's a distant splash, then silence. Two curved claws. Well, I thought the claws were actual claws belonging to a something. So a human. Oops. Could be friendly or not friendly. I don't even know still. Probably not very friendly now. Look into the well. You peer over the edge of the well, but can make nothing out below. Shout down the well. Are you in there? You cry into the darkness. There's no reply. I can move. There's nothing you could do to help the figure. You turn and hurry away across the marsh. Oh well, I feel bad now, but we have no option to try to climb down the well or anything like that. So let's try over here, because I don't... Yeah, we haven't seen this area when it's... It's a marsh now. And this place has changed. The moon gazes down impassively. With each step, your boots sink lower into the mud. Looking around, you can see nothing but endless marsh in all directions, until the strange mists of the backlands swallow up the view. This place is empty and desolate. You stride on across the mud, hoping to luck that you will not sink to your death. let's go north. I mean, we've been over here, but this is when it was not... Well, it's not a valley, it's a marshland. Oh, boy. The moon sets. More stars appear. The ground is sloshy and thick with mud. A moment later, one of your boots disappears entirely, sinking into the muck as far as your knees. Keep going? Turn back. The going is only worse farther ahead. You turn around to head to dry land, but can see nothing but endless marsh in that direction as well. The land has somehow turned and twisted beneath you. Perhaps this is the unstuckness of which you are warned. You take another step, sinking up to your waist this time. I don't remember what the unstuckness was about. Struggle? You struggle and fight your way to the surface, but with every kick you only sink deeper into the mud. You flail around for anything to catch yourself with, and grab a twisting root. The mud is sucking at your boots, trying to drag you into the ground. What am I going to wait for? Hold myself up? No! I hit wait! I meant to press the other thing. You pause for a moment, catching your breath, hanging onto the root, and waiting as the churning mud settles around your lower body. As the waters underneath fall still, the suction grows weaker. A few minutes later, you pull yourself out, covered in mud, but still breathing. But checking yourself over, you see that in the struggle, you have lost a black face mask from your pack. You turn to try to get it from the mud, but has already sunk away and long out of sight. Short of diving into the mud and drowning, you cannot get it back. Feeling regretful, you give up. You keep walking and miraculously find your way onto a submerged spar of solid ground, but it will not extend far. You need to leave this marsh as soon as possible. Okay, might seem a little cheating, but I clicked that thing by mistake, so that's a gameplay element. Actually, see no reason to go that way, so let's go this way. I'm tempted to just go and, you know, not... Back by the old well. You stride onwards towards the dark. Northeast? The cold lingers on. With each step, your boots sink lower into the mud. Same, right? Is this gonna... Day 9. During the past day, you found no new clues. The marshes give way to more solid, barren ground. In the distance, the sun breaks over the horizon. You've been awake all night and are weaker for it. Oh my god, 4 stamina. You walk in the shadow of the towering horns of Ilklala. You must continue your journey, but your exertions have left you weak. Perhaps you should simply rest here for a few hours and regain some strength. I'll do that with 7. You seat yourself and rest. You feel a great calm. The rising winds pull at your hair and cloak. You stand once more. Alright, I'm guessing since we're out of... I do want to visit this village when it's, you know, the before time. So let's go back to the tower. Oh god. You push forwards. One step sinks to your thigh, the next to your money belt. You take another step, sinking up to your waist this time. Pray for aid. You close your eyes and raise a prayer to your graceful god. You feel a graceful peace settling over you, and for the moment you seem to stop sinking, but there's still nowhere to go. You stand absolutely still. You are not sinking, but you are not escaping either. After a few minutes of this, you see the god of grace in your mind's eye. Your god is asking for forgiveness. It cannot save you this time. The whole world is turned against you, and there is no harbor. You flail around for anything to catch yourself with, and grab a twisting root. The mud is sucking at your boots, trying to drag you into the ground. Hold myself up. We lost the black face mask anyway. Yeah, I'd like to leave. Okay, we lost the black face mask. Leave it. I'm hungry. Let's change this thing. Adjust the beam. Keep it up there, but move it this way. Ah, so wonky. So instead of there being, there's just nothing there. Interesting, huh? Let's move along. See, we got more of this marsh, though. That's the only thing. I guess there's nothing... I might not be able to pass this at all. Let's see. If I miss any... If I lose anything else... All bets are off. The thick water around you sucks and sloshes. I want to head up this way. The sun is sinking. You splash on... through the marsh, when you hear something groaning and gobbling in the distance. Gobbling? Wait and listen. You wait, watching to see what the creature is. At first you can barely make anything out. Then, through the parting mists, a dim, glutinous shape lumbers into view. It is a slime eater, or not quite. This creature is grayer and somewhat thinner than the creatures you have seen before. Find a way around... Oh, no, not a spell. Hold on. Find a way around. Find a way... Okay. I lost my, I don't know if you guys can... I don't know. I couldn't hear myself. I don't know if you guys can hear me. Lost my sound there from my speaker with that spell thing coming on. You move sideways, hoping to skirt around the creature, but you hear it stomping and splashing along to keep pace with you. It has clearly caught your scent. The marsh eater lumbers closer, half gliding, half crawling through the thick mud. Hmm. These things can stomp? Let's see if I can cast something that doesn't require stamina. Create quicksand. We don't have that. This is a... Yeah, that's invisible wall. Stamina, no. Maybe more stamina, not less. We don't know what that does. Or the effect it will have on us. Sharpened blade. No thanks. We don't have beeswax anyway. Zip. We don't have a green ring. Goblins too, summon goblin. Alright, I'm gonna draw my sword. You draw your long sword, ready to cut the creature into slimy chunks. Well, it looks like it turns from a blob of slime into a humanoid, or is it a humanoid that turns into a blob of slime. Gotcha! 4, nice. It looks now that I'm using my better sword. The marsh eater growls at you, gobbing filth from its blubbering lips. You swing your sword in a mighty arc. The creature skulks in the brackish water, then rises up and charges. You chop into its body, cutting deeply. Its flesh begins to boil strangely. Then it drops under the water, almost out of sight. Sideswipe it. Standing firm, you swing a mighty blow at the marsh eater. Low in the water, the monster escapes mostly unharmed. The marsh eater lifts up from the water, then crashes back down, bits of its body bubbling and boiling. It begins to lift its bulk out of the water, sending ripples across the marsh. Cut! Oh, I got it. Nice. That was easy. Dropping your weight, you chop a heavy stroke against the marsh eater. The marsh eater roars up, exposing a soft area beneath its chin. You strike with your sword, and it sinks in deep, bringing a fountain of thick green ooze. And then, silence. No stamina lost. Flawless fighting. Thank you very much. You can get some food from these things. The marsh bubbles as the creature sinks into the mud and disappears. You wipe your blade on the marsh lily and then sheath it. Okay. Let's see if we can possibly make it up north without sinking into stuff. The sun has almost set and the sky has turned a deep purple. It will be night soon. The tall grasses reek with a deep smell of death and decay. We'll head this way. Northeast. This is where the town, well, will be. Another night begins. You should find a place to sleep, especially after going all day without eating. You come across the rotten shell of a boat, half buried in the mud. Perhaps once this was a lake? You cannot sleep out here. You will have to find some dry ground somewhere, or else struggle onwards until daybreak. Well, maybe we could find a quiet spot in the mountain, in the forest, I mean. Because this is still a forest. The bog laps and tugs at your boots. Let's go north. You wade on through the marsh, which changes to firmer earth beneath your feet. Trees grow up around you, and suddenly you find yourself in the forest once more. More stars come out. In the darkness, you can see nothing through the curling branches. Okay, we have not been here in any, what do you call it, time, era? Tower's right over there. You walk on beneath the trees. The night air is cold. The air is like ice. Underfoot, the earth has been churned to mud, and you notice the branches on either side of this root are broken. Look at the branches. You check the stem of one of the broken branches. It has not been cut with a blade, but rather, it has been torn apart, as though by something stampeding through. Look at the mud. Uh-oh. You pause to check the mud. Sure enough, you quickly find a sign, a paw print at least twice the size of your palm. Suddenly there's a cracking in the bushes to your right, and you turn to see the towering shape of a wild bear. Roar. Is that two? Kind of looks like it has a sleeping gorilla behind it. Well, too short of a video to leave it here. I can just straight on fight the thing. I can run for it. Pretty sure the bear would win in that chase. I can climb a tree. Bears can climb trees, I think. Depending on how big they are and how big the tree is, I guess also. Or I can try to cast a spell. I lost a black face mask. Could try fear. I have, yap, which is talk with animals. I can do that. So far I'm leaning towards that. I mean, it just wants to eat me or something, so not sure how effective that would be, but that's an idea. Cause depression? I can make it feel so horrible about its existence that it just leaves. How sad. Clone the casters, takes the stamina, I'd rather not lose. Dumb? Yeah. Cause clumsiness, that requires a lot of stamina. Never mind that. Next to the clumsy bear, though, that'd be neat to see. We don't have the staff of oak sapling. Did I do S? Sap is... Right, I did ask. Why did that change to the ground? The map. Talk with animals. Did that... I think I hit everything. Did I try this L? Control non-intelligent creatures. I'm gonna talk with it. I'm gonna try to talk to it. Try diplomacy with a wild bear. Yeah? Grabbing the wig from your pack, you pull it onto your head and weave your spell. A clear message comes through as the spell takes effect. This bear wants food. Okay, draw my sword. Still neat, though. You draw your sword and approach the rearing creature. I'm going to start off strong, and I'm going to defend probably next round. The bear draws itself up to its full height, almost double yours, and opens its paws wide. Killing it quickly will be your best chance. That's what I figured. You swing your sword in a mighty arc, while the wild bear pauses a short way away and swipes with its enormous paws. You chop it back, drawing thick blood. It stomps and staggers. It can barely stand. It squeaks and snuffles, standing up onto its hind legs. Alright. I'm gonna defend this time. It's standing on its hind legs to attack. You can almost smell the creature growing enraged and duck quickly behind a tree. Emitting a thunderous roar, the wild bear thumps forward, unleashing. For a moment, it is close enough that you can smell its terrible breath. You wretch. It rears back, claws raised. Okay, gonna chance a cut here. Oh, it didn't I didn't even need to do that. It was a waste, kind of. You risk an attack. Rushing forward, you charge at the wild bear, but it has read your intention and drops in a crouch. It grunts as it paces from you. Afraid of you, it stumbles away, tail whipped high. Alright, it's stumbling away. Let's sideswipe it. Standing firm, you swing a mighty blow at the wild bear, but it knocks you aside with a paw. The bear emits a terrible, painful roar. It growls and grunts, rearing up, showing its full height. Now we can either defend... Yeah, I'm gonna defend. We need stamina. You sense the creature getting angry and drop quickly into a crouch. Moving much faster than you might have expected, the wild bear rushes towards you, attacking with claws. You swing your arm and refresh your stance. It edges toward the tree line, tail up. I'm gonna cut. Wow, this is a tough opponent. I'm not using my -2 sword, am I? The spell is getting worse. Dropping your weight, you... Well, the smell, actually, is getting worse. I'm like, what spell? Dropping your weight, you chop a mighty stroke against the wild bear, but it has guessed your move and raises its claws to protect itself. You nick the creature's hide. It shuffles back. It's not really attacking much. Sideswipe it. Back against the tree, you deliver a mighty swing at the wild bear, but it bats you back into the mud with its tail. The bear staggers forward, backwards into a tree, which bends and almost snaps. It beats the ground with its thick foot. Beating the ground doesn't mean it's going to attack. Okay, glad I defended there. We will do the killing blow now. You can almost smell the creature coming for your blood and move quickly into a guarded stance. The wild bear makes a lazy swipe with its claws, but you duck. You shake away the pain. You adjust your grip and shift your weight. It hisses and spits, standing up, towering over you. Oh, damn. Oh, my God. The wild bear whips out with its savage claws. You all but drop your sword. If you had, it would have meant certain death. Your stomach turns as you see the bear's claws are red with your blood. The bear drops to all fours and roars. If I defend, it's definitely going to take a point and kill me. I am going to try again because, my God, I'm at one stamina. Standing firm, you swing a mighty blow at the wild bear. Then your sword finds a soft place in the bear's body. It roars and tumbles to the ground, quite dead. Six stamina lost. Shameful. Gonna try again. Thrust. Ah, waste that. Gonna defend here. Warily, you move into a defensive crouch. The wild bear stays low and tries to ram you. You hold your stance. For a moment, it is close enough that you smell its terrible breath, you wretch. It stumbles away. It's stumbling away. On hind legs. Oh, crap. Ow. It's yawning. It's making a lazy swipe with its claws, but you duck. You shake away the pain. You swing your arm and refresh your stance. It opens a wide mouth and yawns. Yawning at me? bear emits a terrible, painful roar. It drops its weight and growls. Ah. Shaking my head over here. You can't see me, but I'm shaking my head. Try again. Okay. Cool. Look at that. I'm gonna defend this time. Good choice. Cut. Boom, much better. One stamina lost. Skilled sword playing. Well, thanks. Third time's a charm. Six stamina is a lot better to end off with. You sheathe your sword and dust yourself down. A bear, however large, is not enough to stop you in your tracks. You have encountered death wraiths and worse. Well, thanks. I mean, it's enough to get me down to one stamina if I start at seven stamina. Or kill me. Did you kill me the second time? I think I got it with one stamina. Alright. I hope we can find some kind of food or something. I can't head here. I guess we have to follow the trail. Which goes around. Okay. Now we've been pretty much over here. This is where we found the Fire Serpent, I think? Somewhere along here, and we decided to go back. If we make it to this, we can get... Oh, look at that furrow in the ground. If we can make it to the tower, we can get a lot of stamina back. So heading north. Come to a fork. We'll head that way. You trace what might be a path, and might be an old river, through the trees of the forest. The sky is already beginning to warm in the east. The forest by night is a terrifying place, full of strange noises and shifting shadows. You are certain something is following you, but when you turn, there's nothing there. Stop and look. Oh, not a spell. That's the second time I did that. I know I can cast something to sense danger, but that takes stamina. You stop and turn about on the spot. There is nothing but twisted trunks and the thorny shrubs that color the gaps in between. Call out? Do I dare? Who's there? You demand. But there is no reply. Most likely whatever is tailing you is a beast. Suddenly you catch a pair of eyes in a low bush. Look at the eyes. The eyes are narrow, with thin vertical pupils and orange irises. A moment later, another pair of eyes appears, followed slowly by a body. These creatures are becoming visible as you watch. Snatacats. Then I will snat attack. Well, are they becoming visible through the foliage, or are they actually invisible and appearing? Which would be interesting. Reminds me of a... Well, not blink dogs, but... Displacer beasts, right? Look at them. They're about the size of large dogs with ugly, snub noses. Their black fur is trimmed with yellow flashes. One of the creatures steps out of the bushes to stand in front of you, then vanishes. I don't think running would be a good idea. Dogs just have a natural inclination to chase whatever runs. Listen. You listen. Footsteps across the leaves and branches cannot be disguised. The cats are pacing towards you. Let's see if I can... I'm not going to try to talk with them, too, but... Maybe control them? That's a force field. I don't have that. have Goblin's Tooth. There's a lowercase g. G-U, I don't have the Vial of Glue. I just lost a friggin' black face mask. So disappointed, I wanted to go back again. But that would have been... Yeah. That would have been cheesy. I really just rewinded the first time because I picked the wrong thing. See the future. I don't have the crystal orb. Fireball will take half my stamina away. I looked at that, yeah. That's it. Alright, I'm not casting a spell. Run for it? What am I running for? I don't know. Stupid. You waste no time but turn and start running across the mud until suddenly you trip and go flying. You have been unlucky and found a fifth snatticat who is lying on the path. The creature swipes at you. You have no choice but to draw your sword. Start off with cut. Good. The snatticat seems to note where you are, then shuts its eyes and vanishes. You take a risk and charge headlong. There's a snarl, and suddenly the snatticat is right in front of you. You turn swiftly to the side and cut into the creature's thick skin. It twists and hisses at you. Should I cut again or sideswipe? Oh, good. Glad I chose that. The snatticat rears back from nowhere and swipes you like a bear. You put all your strength into a sweep of your sword, hoping to finish the monster in a stroke. The blow connects. The snatticat turns on the spot, prowling the space between you. Now I'm going to defend, because I don't think jab or sideswipe is going to do much good. Might have. The snatticat slashes at you with its curved claws. You react on instinct, dodging behind a tree for cover. You are shaken, but mostly unharmed. With a howl, the creature vanishes from sight once more. Now, if I have to fight four more of these, yeah, we're just doomed. I didn't see the how many points it took away, but it has three now. You twist your blade around for a wild blow, but the snatticat does not reappear, and your blade finds only empty air. Yeah, I'm literally doing nothing to it. You turn your grip around for a vicious attack, but the snatticat remains invisible, so you miss. Gonna defend. It's just not doing anything. Nothing else happens. You wait, eyes fixed on the empty air. Good. The snatticat hangs back, swiping. Its fur seems to bristle with electricity. You bring your blade about for a vicious blow, and the strike cuts deep. It seems to flicker in and out of visibility, perhaps in pain. It shuts its eyes and vanishes. That's why. Good. The snatticat is cautious, opening its eyes just long enough to snap its jaws. You turn your sword around for a vicious attack, and the blow lands deep. The snatticat wails in agony with a keening, almost human sound. It drops to a crouch, and its eyelids fall shut once more. When it's invisible, it turns its eyes too, so then it's just finding me through, well, scent and its hearing, which is going to be more sensitive than mine. Oh, ouch. You flick out your blade at the snatticat, but it materializes in a whirl of claws and swiping paws, and swipes you easily aside as it comes for your blood. You bring your hand up to staunch your wound. The snatticat licks its lips with glee. It fades from view as it turns about on the spot. The snatticat appears just long enough to bat at you, as though you were a toy. You fling your sword up and knock the beast back. You feel yourself weakening. The creature almost seems seems almost to grin as it realizes. It closes its eyes once more. Before it fades, you see it is tensing, preparing to pounce. Can we beat it with a cut? Yes. Goodbye. Somehow you sense the snatticat crouching low, ready to spring for your throat. Hurrying backwards, you shift your grip in time for the creature to land on the blade of your upheld sword. Your sword plunges deep into the creature's throat. It drops to the ground, and those delicate, powerful eyelids close. Four stamina lost. Competent combat. Oh, God. The other snatticats prowl closer, slowly circling around you. Back away? You back away slowly, and the creatures watch you with their bright orange eyes, but they do not follow. One by one, they disappear from view as you enter the trees. You have found one new clue. What could that be? I really can't fight anything else. That's my clue. Snatticats are invisible. They're invisible when they close their eyes. Okay. That was Owie. No more battles, please. Oh. Things move in the canopy all around you. In the distance, the sun breaks over the horizon. You have been awake all night and are weaker for it. You are physically exhausted, all but unable to continue. Dropping to your knees, you whisper a last desperate prayer to Korga. You are answered with the merest glimmer of strength. Something looms between the trees, and you emerge into something of a clearing to find a towering stone structure built into the earth. Not a tower, but one leg of an enormous arch. Who could have built such an incredible thing, and how long ago was it done? Below the broken bridge, day 10. During the past day, you have become weak and found one new clue. Wow. Okay, so that's what that is. I really thought it was just a bridge, but there's more. There's a lot more going on underneath, or at least there was. Kind of looks like, I don't know. Something from... It definitely looks something of a impressive culture, right? What does this say? Beneath the bridge. Oh, it is a bridge. But there's... It looks like there's something going on. It's a multi-leveled bridge, at the very least. Please... I require solace. The trees are thinner, replaced by climbing weeds and shrubs that grow in and around the broken stones of the bridge. You make your way to a point where the path splits. Look up at the arch. You crane your neck back to look at the stone pillar. It is made of bricks, each one a normal size, but thousands upon thousands in number. They climb up into the air in a stack no wider than a tree, but three times taller than the tallest in the forest. Look higher. Then, almost beyond what you can see, the stone begins to form a curve, branching into the beginning of an arch. But the rest of the arch has crumbled into ruin, and this single leg is all that remains. The pillar might be climbable, otherwise several paths lead into the trees. Okay, back where I came. Head south. We can head west. We can climb the pillar. Hope that doesn't take stamina. Or we can head north. Let's see if we can climb this without dying. Intrigued, you approach one of the brick pillars to see if it might be climbable. Indeed, the stones are worn and filled with pock-marked holes in fingertips, but you cannot seem to manage to climb up while holding your sword. You will have to unbuckle your blade if you want to climb up. Unbuckle my blade. Alright, guys. Well, we know what is this way. We came from here. I mean, there might be something unknown in this area, but I'm betting it's just more wild beasts that want to attack me. We also head north. So what do you think? I mean, Number one with stamina, only at two. Climbing sometimes takes stamina. That could kill us. Number two, we have to unbuckle our blade. We might lose our plus two sword, I'm assuming. Let me take an item check here. We have that stuff. We have a plus two sword, silver chain, minus two sword. We still have those gems. Hoping we could trade those in somewhere. I don't want to look at that, actually. We have this stuff. Looks like we have everything except the black face mask. So, let me know what you guys think. Should we climb up? Or just continue north, at least for now? Which heads to this mound of something or other. There's some kind of house here. The rest of the arch is here. And there's a lake. And how do I... Where's the, Oh, it's here. At the lake. Alright. So, leave your votes below, por favor. Let me know what you think. Should I try to climb up this thing? See what might be at the top, or at least a little farther up, or should I head north and continue to, you know, that mound of whatever that is, clearing the house, and then the lake and the tower. So north or up. As always, appreciate all the votes, comments, and such. Thanks so much. And yeah, enduring, grow strong. See you next week.